3 years ago, we watched Kristian Blummenfelt take gold in the Tokyo Olympics wearing the Insane suit. It was a much hyped suit after countless R&D testing with bold thermoregulating claims. Then, in his first ever full distance triathlon, he won Ironman Cozumel in 7:21:12 using the same but aero long distance version of the suit. Not long after, he posted a 6:44:26 in the Sub 7 project and won the Ironman World Championships in St. George. This suit achieved a lot in a short space of time, and it certainly hasn't stopped there. Of course, let's not take anything away from Kristian's almighty efforts. It's not all down to the suit, but there is no denying that the kit is incredibly important, particularly when you're racing in brutal conditions like Tokyo, Cozumel, or even Kona, in races that come down to a point of a second where 1 or 2 watts can be the difference between staying in touch with the pack or not. Everything has to be perfect. The R&D behind this kit has to be next level, and the brand behind this suit, Surpas. And they have created a whole line of additional suits and kit with this trickle down of next level R&D. And you have the chance to get your hands on some of that today for free. So stay tuned, all will be revealed soon. But before we get to that, who and why Surpas? Yep, so it's a brand that won't be familiar to anyone really. It's brand new, but at the same time, it's actually steeped in history. So Surpas is actually a family-led business and also the founders of high-end endurance and outdoor sportswear brand Trimtex. Now, Trimtex itself was founded way back in 1976 when entrepreneur Harald Alglund saw a niche in durable clothing for the orienteering market. In 1979, they created cycling clothing, and by the 1980s, they were already supplier to 8 national teams during the World Cup in orientation. Then they began producing ski kit and quickly found themselves kitting the Norwegian national team. Fast forward to 2011 and Trimtex started a triathlon line, then supported the Norwegian national team, and the rest is history. Well, until they called it Surpas instead. I know, that may seem confusing, and it was to me initially, but it does actually make a lot of sense. Now, as you've heard, Trimtex is a huge sportswear business. They're supplying high-performance sportswear for triathlon, running, cycling, orienteering, athletics, cross-country skiing, and many other sports. That experience, know-how, and textile expertise from winter sports has allowed them to become one of the biggest and best triathlon sportswear brands in the world. What they have achieved within the triathlon space in a relatively short space of time is really quite impressive. But with that growing sector and the need to tailor specifically to the unique needs and ambitions of the triathlon community, Surpas has broken free, broken off, and they are full steam ahead.
So we've already won the Olympic once, and Surpas wants to do it once again. To do so, we have to do everything one step better than what we did 3 years ago. Surpas, a new brand, it's about what we do every single day, taking it one step further.
So here I have the Insane suit, the top end suit, the same suit we saw Kristian wearing to these incredible results just now with a different logo. And they now have Gustav Eden back in their roster, who actually helped to develop this original suit for the Tokyo Olympics with the Norwegian Triathlon Federation. The big goal with this suit was to aid and help the athletes handle the heat and humidity expected on race day in Tokyo, balancing aerodynamics, hydrophobic properties, flexibility, fit, and comfort. And we actually saw Kristian Gustav testing these suits in the lead up to the Tokyo Olympics with countless core body temperature sensors on their bodies, finally managing to produce a suit that apparently resulted in the lowest skin temperature and highest heat flux values recorded, indicating that the Insane suit gave the best heat dissipation performance for Tokyo. And well, if Kristian's result is anything to go by, I'd say job well done. So the next task was to create a long distance suit, and of course with that, a need for even more or better aerodynamic properties. So in come the sleeves, not only with trip strips on them built into the fabric, but also these turbulators. That never gets old. But apart from sounding cool, a turbulator is a device that turns a laminar boundary layer into a turbulent boundary layer. Essentially, they act in a similar way to the dimples on a golf ball, thereby improving the airflow and aerodynamics. The same is true for the trip strips, which are actually strategically placed with differing distances, particularly on the back as they go down. And It's paper light with a woven elastane polyester material and gripper that is even woven into the fabric to reduce that weight even further. And should you want to go full pro mode, you can actually have it fully customized just for you with all your sponsor logos and whatnot. And calf sleeves with more turbulators. Who wouldn't want more of those, which claim to save a further 4 to 6 watts? So, let's see how this R&D has trickled down. Introducing the Pursuit Suit, the next in line with a slightly more affordable price tag in comparison to the Insane, yet with tons of the tech gained from developing that Insane suit. More or less all the seams and lines of the suit replicate that of the Insane to maximize aerodynamics and comfort, but with a slightly different material, of course. Instead, they've used a fabric from Italian maker Carvico, which is actually one of the best suppliers of technical sports material on the market, which has actually also received many quality and performance certificates. And they've even used a special compressive fabric in the crotch slash back area that apparently has a great retention. In fact, this is the very same suit that we at GTN will be racing in very soon in our GTN colors. And you too can get your team kitted out in the same way in your team colors. Now for the fun and exciting part, the giveaway, your chance to get your hands on a Pursuit suit like this and the Insane calf sleeves with the turbulators. Yes, so to enter into that, you just need to go down to the description below this video, click on the link that's going to take you through to a page in which you need to answer a question about these suits. So hopefully you've been listening. There'll be one very lucky winner who will be repping this kit like Gustav Eden and Kristian Blummenfelt, maybe even setting records like Kristian and Gustav. You never know. Well, best of luck to you. Hope you've enjoyed today's video. If you have, please do give it a thumbs up, give it a like, and don't forget to subscribe. See you next time.